डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टूडे वी विल डिस्कस द मोशन ऑफ अ वन डिमेंशनल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर यूजिंग विद एंड विदाउट डैम्पिंग इफेक्ट, एंड देन वी विल ड्राइव दिस प्रोग्राम बाय यूजिंग द आइलर मेथड, एंड ग्राफिकली वी विल डिस्कस द वेरिएशन ऑफ एक्सेलेरेशन वर्सेस टाइम, वेलोसिटी वर्सेस टाइम एंड पोजिशन वर्सेस टाइम. फर्स्ट, वट इज़ द वन डिमेंशनल हार्मोनिक ऑसिलेटर? As we know that the harmonic oscillators are of two type, one is the mechanical oscillator and second one is the electrical oscillator. In case of mechanical oscillator, we will always discuss the example of a mass that is attached to a spring, and in case of electrical oscillator, we will study the circuit of L and C. And in case of ideal mechanical and electrical oscillator, there is no energy loss. That means the energy remains constant. So the oscillation will remain of same amplitude. There is no decrease in amplitude. That's why that is called the without damping effect. But there is always some presence of resistance forces like drag, like depends upon the resistance depends upon the drag. In addition to the structure also, friction forces presence. So there will always be some energy loss. So due to energy loss, the amplitude goes on decreases. And at the end, it will dies out. So that oscillator is known as the damped oscillators. And we will, in this article, we will discuss the damped oscillators. For this, as we know that when a mass attached to a spring is displaced from their original position, it will move to some extreme position, and that displacement is known as x. But there is always tendency of the mass to regain its original position, that is known as the equilibrium position. So there will be a force developed which is opposite to the work done to move a mass from original to extreme position, and that force is known as the restoring force. It will act as a opposite direction, and the energy at the extreme position is stored in the form of work done is known as the potential energy, and at the mean position the mass has a energy, kinetic energy, and therefore the one form of energy is converted into the another form of energy, potential is converted into the kinetic and vice versa. As restoring force depends upon the displacement, how much displacement has been taken by a mass from their original position to the extreme positions. So and restoring force is always in opposite direction, that's why we have taken here a negative sign, and K is known as the restoring constant. And next is the damping force. Damping force depends upon the velocity, so it is proportional to the rate of change of displacement, and this is equal to FD is equal to minus of gamma dot x, and this gamma is known as the damping constant. So that means two forces are acting on the system. One is the force, restoring force, and second one is due to the damping factor. So net force is equal to sum of these two, which is equal to minus of kx and minus of gamma dot x. Now we want to find out the acceleration. As we know that according to Newton's law, force is equal to the mass into acceleration, and acceleration is equal to minus kx by m minus gamma x dot by m. Here we have divide by mass on both sides, and as we know that acceleration is equal to the double derivative of displacement, so it can be written as d2x by dt square is equal to minus kx by m minus x by m, and in case of velocity we have written dx by dt. Now take the all the values on one side, and that is the left side. So we got a position d2x by dt, we got a differential equation d2x by dt square plus x by m dx by dt plus k by m into x is equal to 0. So this is the second order differential equation. Now next is here. Now let us take x by m is equal to some constant b and k by m is equal to omega square. So we can rewrite this differential equation as d2x by dt square plus 2b dx by dt plus omega square x is equal to 0, and we can write it as the double derivative as double dot and 2b x dot plus omega square x is equal to 0. Here omega is our natural frequency, b is our damping term equation. And so this is a linear homogeneous equation of second order equation. So let us find the solution of this equation. कंसिडर एक्स इज इक्वल टू ए इंटू ई रेस टू पर ए टी ए सॉरी अल्फा टी. अल्फा एंड ए आर कॉन्स्टेंट. सो लेट अस टेक द फर्स्ट डेरीवेटिव देन सेकेंड डेरीवेटिव एंड पुट दीज टू वैल्यूज इन अवर इक्वेशन नंबर वन. आफ्टर सब्सिट्यूटिंग वी विल गेट अल्फा स्क्वेयर ए इंटू ई रेस्ट पर अल्फा टी प्लस टू बी अल्फा ए ई रेस्ट पर अल्फा टी प्लस अमेगा स्क्वेयर ए इंटू ई रेस्ट पर अल्फा टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो. दिस इज जस्ट अ सिंपल डेरीवेटिव एंड टेक द कॉमन पार्ट एंड दैट टर्म इज इक्वल टू जीरो. एज वी नो दैट ए इंटू ई रेस्ट पर अल्फा टी दैट इज अवर सोल्यूशन. सो इट इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो. दैट मीन्स टर्म अल्फा स्क्वेयर प्लस टू बी अल्फा प्लस अमेगा स्क्वेयर इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो दिस इज अवर क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन इन अल्फा. दैट मीन्स वी हैव टू रूट ऑफ अल्फा. That we will define it as alpha 1 and alpha 2. And by using a determinant method, minus b plus minus b square minus 4ac divided by 2a, we have find out the two roots of alpha. So, one is alpha 1, that is equal to minus b plus b square minus omega square, and second one is negative part. Minus b square minus omega square, and substitute the value of b and omega. As we have previously defined, b is equal to minus gamma by 2m plus b square gamma square by 4m square, and omega square is equal to k by m. Similarly, substitute here. And now the net solution is, it can be written as x is equal to a1 into e raised per alpha 1 plus a2 e raised per alpha 2. Substitute the value of roots. And then we will get a final solution, final displacement of the harmonic oscillator, that is e raised per minus bt, that this is a common part, a1 e raised per b square minus omega square raised per 1 by 2 plus a2 e raised per minus b square minus omega square raised per 1 by 2 into t. And e raised per minus bt, that means displacement is decreasing. But how it is decreasing? This is exponentially decreasing with the time. Displacement means amplitude. So that means amplitude of oscillation is decreasing with the factor of e raised to power minus bt. And in inside term b square minus omega square, it can be positive, it can be zero, or it can be negative. From here we can define a three type of damping. As we know that there are three type of damping. One is heavy damping, critical damping, and light damping. So when b square minus omega square is positive, that means b square is greater than omega square. B square is our, what is b? That is our damping factor. So it makes the system non-oscillatory because this term is positive term. And if we consider b square minus omega square is equal to is negative, this means b square is less than omega square. So because here the frequency part is large, so that's why this system is oscillatory, because the here is a frequency, and for the oscillations we need frequency. And but in heavy damping, because frequency is very very less, the damping is underestimate the frequency, that's why this is non-oscillatory in nature. And third one is the critical damping. In this case, if we take b square minus omega square is equal to zero, that means damping is proportional to the frequency part. So this behavior is also equal to non-oscillatory, or we know called it as a deadbeat oscillators. So these are all for the damping part. And next is for undamped oscillator, the damping term is equal to zero because there is no damping. So we can say gamma is equal to zero and only restoring force will act. In that case, F is equal to minus of Kx. So this is a diagram for the damping part. But in case of undamped oscillator, the oscillation will remains of same amplitude. But in case of damping, we see that once the amplitude is at higher height, and with the time it is goes on decreasing. So this is the, due to the damping, and due to the three, there are different types of damping. This one is known as the critical damping, that is deadbeat. So this is this. Now we will discuss the algorithm.